To make life easier for the homework in Chemsketch, I want to just show you a few basic things that you can do with it that are not self-explanatory, but once you see them, they'll make a lot of sense. And the first one is to show lone pairs. So let's say I have a water here, H2O, and I want to show two sets of lone pairs above and below the oxygen. To do that, the easiest way that I found is to come over here to this label tab, ABC, click off somewhere, and enter in two periods, same as two dots, and you'll see them right there. Now, if you want to make them larger or smaller, what you need to do is come up here to the box or lasso, select them, and you'll see they're surrounded by a box. Now, if you drag this, it'll make the spots bigger or smaller. So now you can see they're larger. So to place them above the oxygen, what you want to do is just drag them over, and for fine placement, you can click on it and then use the arrows of your keyboard to move them over to exactly the right position. So there's one set. Now if I copy, which is Control C, and then paste, I can select the other set to go there, and I can move those in. So it looks like this. So now we can see lone pairs above and below. I'll shrink them down a little bit so they look a little bit nicer. And there we've got it. So this is an easy way to draw lone pairs when we need to for the assignment. The second thing I want to show you how to do is in the Newman projections, to change the labels at the ends of the lines is a little bit tricky. So let's first select a Newman projection. We'll go up to Templates, Template Window, and right on this pull-down bar, I did Newman's last time, you'll see a large variety of things. You want the Newman projections. Now let's take this one here, and you're going to left-click on it, which will select it, and you can see that we're going to basically stamp that onto our paper here like this. Now, to get it off of our arrow, I just hit Escape, and that clears it and allows us to go back to it. Now, looking at the Newman projection, this is all one image here. But what we need to do is break it down to the individual images so that we can change the labels. To do that, you need to make sure that it's selected. Go up to the top here where it says Group and click on it, and that's going to ungroup everything. Basically, it breaks it down to its individual parts. So now if we click off of it and come back, we can see that we can select the individual elements that are associated with the structure. So to change one, we're going to go to Structure, and let's just put a chlorine where the bromine is. You select the chlorine here, come over, click where the bromine is, and that substitutes a chlorine into that position. And you can do that with whatever you want, doing it this way, or if you add a C, for example, that's going to make a CH3 to fill out your structure for you. So that's how you go about changing the labels on your Newman projections. The final thing I want to show you is how to draw structures by dragging your arrow to form bonds instead of just clicking on things. So let's make a carbon and another carbon. Okay, so there's two carbons there. Now, if I want to put three CH3s on the end here, I've got two ways to do it. The first way is to select here and click three times. One, two, three. And you can see that it makes an arrangement that looks like this. But what if instead of having this one pointed up in the air this way, I'd rather have it pointed in line with the original two carbons of the structure? So to do that, I'm going to select what was made and delete it. Come back over to the normal draw button. And instead of just clicking, I'm going to drag a line out, and that's going to put it in the new position. So in this way, you can basically add the carbons in whatever direction you want to help show with what you want to see in the structure. So we have the lone pairs here on how to do that. we have the substitution and the Newman projections by ungrouping your structure. And then finally, drawing the carbons in the correct arrangement by using the dragging approach instead of the simple clicking approach.